Hi everybody, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to see how to run Stumble Guys on PC. Here you are able to watch it on your screen. It will be possible to easily download and set up Stumble Guys and enjoy playing this game on our Windows PC using our gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. Then it's time to have fun, let's go! Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, go into this URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. You don't need to type it, because I provided the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. After clicking on this link, we reach the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we will use to get access to the game Stumble Guys on PC. It is now obvious that we have a great deal of pros of using this emulator. Custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we are ready to start downloading the Stumble Guys by simply clicking on this button, Download Stumble Guys on PC, that I have marked in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It's an executable file. What we have to do now is to run the executable file, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the system. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installation software better. The installation software is very simple to use. It is made up of two possibilities, install and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path does. We simply click on it. And so we note that we display here the path where the emulator can be installed. If we choose to change this directory, we must click on the browse button, and therefore we pick another directory and set up the emulator exactly where we choose. To keep it simple, just leave it by default. Then, I click on back. Therefore I just click install. At this moment, prior to starting setting up that emulator, will also be possible that it will present us one or more software offers to set up on our computer. Because I do not want any of those computer software, I simply just click several times on the reject button. Fantastic! The setup commences and it's going to go forward with the download of those megabytes that are displayed on that screen. As you download it, it may be a bit more or less megabytes. The download rate might go faster or slower, determined by your type of connection and according to the speed capacity of the emulator web servers. Now they're progressing superbly fast. The download is done, then instantly it continues with the setup phase. The installation will take more or less time depending on the power of your computer. The more robust it actually is, the shorter the software installation time and or vice versa. If we integrate the download and setup phase, it may take a considerably long time, so have patience. It is by now ended for me. At this time, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will fill up, and when it attains the end, the emulator will be launched for the first time. The fact is that the emulator has been started, here for the very first time. And consequently LD Store is instantly started, that is a sort of Google Play. This is not the optimal way to install the game, and therefore I do not propose it, given that from time to time the LD Store sets up an out-of-date version of the Android game. I am going to explain to you how you can set up the video game working with the Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. The initial thing we have to begin doing is to head to the computer's desktop by clicking on this icon that I am pointing out in green. Before we keep going, as you will notice, it created two app icons here on the PC desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer icon is the one we are interested in. Each time we desire to run Stumble Guys on the desktop or laptop, we twice click this icon and therefore use the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything like this. In reality, it is an icon that we may most likely never ever work with. Let me conduct the next phase, which is actually a must-have, and that is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. To execute this, we will browse there to System Apps, we click on. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you understand, the Google Play is started. In this case, we must log on. Currently, once we're right here, we must absolutely do the next step, which is mandatory. Therefore, we click on Sign In. At present, it shows Checking Info. It might in some cases get stopped at Checking Info, and it doesn't move forward. In this case, you may attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours and it will most likely be fixed. At present, we're going to type our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For example, you can use the very same email address you are using currently in your YouTube account. So that I am going to enter my data and I'll revisit after I have completed it. Voila, info typed. Below is Google welcoming us and presenting us the terms of service. We are going to accept them simply by clicking on, I agree. Then, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it checked and it'll create a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. By now Google Play is started by default and immediately. In case that the Google Play is not started automatically and you do not know how to launch it by hand, I demonstrate how to do this. First thing is to go to the emulator desktop by clicking this app icon noted in green. Presently we head to the system apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Great, we are right inside of Google Play. What we intend to do will be go here to search for apps and games. And then we are going to research Stumble Guys. Now there we have got it, we will select the first result. On this page we have got the Android game. Let's quickly then click here on the install option that I'm highlighting now in green. This action will commence the software setup. At this time it is going to download on your PC and set up the game. It may take a while or it could be very quick. That all will depend on the web connection. This has actually finished installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking the following option I'm highlighting in green, so that you can launch Stumble Guys for the first time. You are now on the emulator desktop, and then we are on the way to click on that new Stumble Guys icon that has been created. Your game app is started for the first time. Here we have it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the sound level of this emulator. This is here, we have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we should activate the big screen, for which we have two options. This one is actually the very first one, we simply click on that icon that I'm pointing out in green. Thus the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. If ever we would like to launch the app using all the screen, we click on this particular icon. And as a result we would likely without a doubt be experiencing the gameplay in full screen setting. To exit the full screen mode, push the F11 key. And so we would certainly just end up being in standard screen mode. At this point, I am choosing to clarify you the keys mapping and that is quite interesting. This way we will certainly be able to make use of the game app more effortlessly. The very first task is to click this keyboard icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to complete the appropriate setups. I will keep the default configuration, but if you prefer to change that, you can easily do it with no problem. I use this occasion to say that occasionally, when launching the game a black screen appears. If this is so and you notice the black screen and this emulator fails to start, I propose an achievable fix. We can click here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator preferences, in the advanced selection we have got a large number of resolutions. That is the resolution that we have currently chosen by default, therefore we must select any of these other resolutions, for example this particular one down below. We go for it and afterwards mouse click save. It will probably ask us to restart the emulator and once restarted, most likely the emulator will begin and that black display will vanish. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Occasionally it occurs that the emulator is started in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese. And so to place it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus there throughout various other configuration settings, we click on the language drop down. We should decide on the language we want, English, Chinese, etc. After the language is decided, we would save, the emulator will restart, and also the video game, the next time we launch it, will as well be in the picked language. Presently, you can find another point that we need to take into consideration, and it is that we will receive an email saying that a new machine has been connected to our own Google account. It will certainly ask us if we're the people who have associated with that device. Yes, we shouldn't be troubled, considering that the emulator is acting as a Google Android smartphone or tablet. And in order to find which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Be sure you browse here to the model selection. And there we learn that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for my video tutorial. I hope that you liked it, particularly that you found it useful. If that's the case, give it a nice thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and any remarks, issues or suggestions, leave them in the comment box down below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel. I conduct live streams on occasion. You have it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Check out any of those videos that happens to be appearing on the listing of videos to watch, and see you in the following online videos. Bye.